There's a point in any creative process when, having spent years pouring your energy and passion into a project, you must step back and allow others to experience what you have created. For the developers at Monolith, that time is now. With only weeks until the official launch of Middle-earth: Shadow of Mordor, the team is attending conferences and exhibitions across the country.
We really have to reach out to as many people as we possibly can, getting the word out, letting people know about the game, letting them discover it.
This is our opportunity to really get out in front of everybody and show them all of our hard work, and to get their responses and to get their feedback directly to us from what they've seen.
At Comic-Con in San Diego, the press and fans are able to discuss the game with the developers and Troy Baker, who plays Talion.
I was really excited when we did our panel to see the anticipation and the excitement that people had to sit and just hear about the game.
Comic-Con was really about the legitimacy and the authenticity of our story within the canon of Middle-earth. Comic-Con makes you feel and realize that this game is part of this larger sort of tapestry of pop culture, and to be a part of that and to be there alongside these amazing movies and comics and TV shows, and just being a part of that is just super inspiring.
But it's the Penny Arcade Expo in Seattle which is special to the team. The largest event in North America focused entirely on gaming takes place in Monolith's hometown, meaning the entire team, their friends and their family, can attend and see firsthand fans' reaction to their hard work.
Here at PAX, it's people that are in your community specifically and getting to have that direct interaction with you and the dev team, and it's kind of great to have that.
It's very much about embracing the gamer, letting them see the games that they love.
These are just tens of thousands of like-minded people who are into the same stuff, hanging out together, having a good time.
At the Warner Brothers booth, the atmosphere is charged with excitement as the team interacts with fans and immerses them in all things Middle-earth.
You'll get a chance to meet a couple of these really amazing orcs. They'll take their picture with you, they'll bite on your arm, chew on your hair, whatever you want them to do. In addition to that, we also have somebody here that will be branding people. And then after that, you'll be able to come in here, you get your hands on the game, you get a chance to play it for the first time, and you see what it's really all about.
One after the other, players step up and take on the role of Talion for the first time.
So fans are getting to run around in the open world, they're getting to hunt down orc war chiefs. Every single person that plays is going to get a unique experience compared to everyone else.
The purity of it is, you know, having these people just be gamers with no agenda, you know? They just want to know if it's fun or not.
Soon, fan reaction begins to filter back to the team. It turns out the game is meeting, even surpassing, expectations.
I really like the fact that you can possess as many enemies as you want.
And like the thought of having a ridiculous army is like really kind of exciting.
Being able to go in and see their strengths and their weaknesses and just like who's above them and how you can kind of go through the ranks.
You make your move, but everybody else is making their moves at the same time.
It was utter bedlam, and it was awesome.
To really just see so many fans playing it, to walk away with smiles, to kind of have their own stories, it's just incredible. Like, that's the most important thing.
Every time somebody makes an exclamation of happiness or joy or goes, oh my gosh, that was so cool, you can only hope and dream that people will react like that.
Buoyed by the positive response, the team can breathe a momentary sigh of relief as they head back and ready the game in time for its debut on September 30th.
You can't wait for someone to get their hands on that controller and sit down and put that disc in and play it, because that's all your hard work. That's your baby that you've sweat and cried over and bled over. So yeah, I can't wait for that day.
We've done everything we can, and now it's just the anticipation of how that's really gonna be received by the public at large once the game is released.
I don't know that it's really sunk in that the journey is almost over. I'm still in this nervous, anxious state waiting for it to launch. I think we've got to get it out there and see how people react before I'll finally be able to take a real deep breath.
On the final episode, with the game set to ship, we talk with key members of the team as they reflect back on their long journey from creation to completion.